As a systemic autoimmune disease that can affect every single organ system, it's always easy to include the lupus in the differential of any non-specific symptom. In this day and age when media is omnipresent, it's very common for patients to look up their symptoms online. And looking at the classic American College of Rheumatology lupus criteria, which, and there's 11 of them, it's very easy for patients to identify things that they have. So putting those things together makes patients very worried that they actually have a systemic autoimmune disease, and this leads either to a lot of unnecessary diagnostic tests and, in the most unfortunate cases, unnecessary treatments with medications that have a lot of side effects. The problem is that we do not have lupus diagnostic criteria. So the gold standard for diagnosis is technically expert opinion. And the reason it's like that is because the criteria may miss some cases, or the criteria may be misinterpreted. If you have somebody with a low titer positive ANA, has some mild rash that goes away in a couple of hours after being exposed to the sun, in the past says that they had this redness over the cheeks, it would be tempting to say that that is a systemic autoimmune disease. However, a positive ANA is present in a third of healthy Americans. One third. So that's millions of people that walk around with this test, and not all of them have systemic lupus. Lupus rashes are inflammatory. All lupus symptoms are inflammatory in nature, and they last a while. No lupus symptom will be transient. No lupus rash will resolve in 2 hours. Nothing will resolve overnight. The rule of thumb is lupus symptoms are persistent, they're inflammatory, rashes will be elevated, palpable, and it's always important to run these symptoms by somebody who knows the disease rather than start unnecessary treatments, because the treatments in these non-specific situations can be much more dangerous than the disease itself.